When Sheffield United were relegated on the final day of the season back in 1994, no one would have believed that it would have been the start of a 12-year absence from the top flight. What followed was a period of mixed fortunes and uncertainty for the club as the Blades went through a succession of managers and went further and further into debt. In December 1999, the club turned to self-confessed Sheffield United fan Neil Warnock in a bid to re-establish the Blades as a promotion challenger. At this time though, with over £20 million of debt, the priority was cutting costs and wages. But slowly, United regrouped, going from strength to strength both on and off the field, reaching the semi-finals of the FA Cup, League Cup and the Division 1 playoff finals in 2003. 2004 and 5 saw Sheffield United narrowly miss out on a place in the playoffs, finishing 8th in both seasons. Finally, in April 2006, Neil Warnock's ultimate goal was achieved as Sheffield United secured their place back amongst the elite of English football, the Premiership. The push for the Premiership began way back in the summer of 2005 with the acquisitions of new signings Lillian Nallis, Paul Eiffel and Danny Webber. With the addition of Craig Short and Neil Shipperley, manager Neil Warnock was confident of success despite the critics.
I think when you look at the bookies, I think we were 8th, 9th or 10th, depending on which bookie you had. A lot of big clubs around on massive wage bills, and although we'd increased our wage bill and spent a little bit on transfers, we'd recouped that with the sale of Andy Gray and John Arley and one or two others.
Phil Jagielka gave the squad another massive boost when he turned his back temporarily on the Premiership, turning down a £4 million offer from Wigan. A busy pre-season included a 10-day trip to China where the team played 3 games in different cities.
It was a difficult pre-season. We'd never been abroad, you know, let alone the Far East. And, you know, we had a lot of obstacles to overcome. I know Andy Gray came back. He couldn't cope with it early doors. And quite a few injuries. Eiffel did his shoulder. Danny Webber got injured. So it was a bit of a disaster to some extent. But it was a great, because I think it opened everybody's eyes up about how we've got to stick together as a group. You know, it was easy to throw the towel in. And we didn't. We rolled our sleeves up and stuck at it out there and came back from China, I thought, a lot stronger.
And so, on a sunny August day, live on Sky TV, Sheffield United and Leicester City kicked off the Championship season.
And there certainly has been expectation in this part of the world. A disappointing finish to last season, but the biggest splashing of the cash at Bramall Lane for many a season has brought with it real hopes that promotion will be a reality come May in 46 games' time for Neil Warnock. Mason from Lancashire is the referee on a pleasant afternoon in Yorkshire. Well, fasten your seatbelts, here we go again. The Football League is back.
It's also the other side of the coin. We get them perfect on the first day of the season.
Eiffel, did Douglas bring him down? Yes, he did. Disaster for Leicester and Rab Douglas. He should really have dealt with that, and he has gifted a penalty kick to the hosts.
Well, I cannot believe Rab Douglas has not got this ball. He does put his foot up Paul Eiffel, but whether he's backed out of it, bottled out of it, decided not to go with his hands, goes with his feet, it's poor, poor goalkeeping, and he deserves to give away that penalty, because all Eiffel does is get a little touch on it, and Rab Douglas, not very good, Rab. Well, he hasn't had a touch, Andy Gray.
It's Gray, it's in. And the first goal of the new season is scored by Andy Gray for Sheffield United.
Well, he nearly redeemed himself, Rab Douglas, because he knew exactly where this ball was going. But it's so far in the corner, even though he dives the right way, he makes that little step to the right. There's not too much spring from his feet, but he's down there to that left-hand side. And Andy Gray, with that most significant touch that he's had in this first half, just slots it into that far corner.
Lee Mason stoops into it, and that's to Leicester's advantage. Good Johnson for Connolly. De Vries in the centre. Still it's Connolly, and it's over the line and in. Now, tinged with controversy after it hit the referee, but no doubt about the finish. Well, we're in for a very interesting end to this match. This is Eiffel. And off the legs of Douglas, Cabalot to follow up.
Given a penalty. The referee has given a penalty for an accidental handball.
For the second time this afternoon, Sheffield United have a penalty kick. It's Cabba. It's 2-1 Sheffield United.
Well, that's a masterclass in penalty taking from Sheffield United. Absolutely superb. But this penalty is dispatched absolutely beautifully by Steve Cabba. Rab Douglas this time doesn't dive the right way, but he wouldn't have saved it anyway.
Here's Gillespie. That's a testing ball. And Eiffel on his debut has wrapped up the point surely for Sheffield United.
Well, this is absolute quality. This really is a beautiful goal. Keith Gillespie's cross is just inviting someone to run across the face of the goal and go and head it. And Paul Eiffel is the one who does it. Look at that run, he times it to perfection. And then he glances the header to the side. I just think he's just level there, Keith Gillespie, to be onside in that position. But you cannot blame Rab Douglas one iota with this, because that is put away beautifully.
Blades go in search of a fourth. Great work from Cabba. This is Montgomery, time to take a touch. Pounced around like a pinball off blue shirts. Eventually Bromby can collect for Gillespie now.
Oh, Nick Montgomery's just got to strike it. Steve Cabba will be thinking, well, why did I give it to him?
Michael has put himself out of a really difficult position, and a goal has been gifted to Bromby. Leicester City have fallen apart.
Did it come off his hand, Lee Bromby? Just as that ball spins across, it was a fantastic ball in between the defence and the goalkeeper. And we've seen the hesitancy of Rab Douglas. He's hesitant once again, but I'm not sure whether Lee Bromby makes contact with his chest or his hand. I think it might have been his hand. Look at the ball come across. Is it his right hand? Still couldn't tell from that angle. Oh, it's off his chest. Sorry, Lee, I'll give you the benefit of the doubt. And enjoy that goal.
He'll enjoy it. Leicester City certainly won't. It's all gone horribly wrong at Bramall Lane. And certainly no defeat for Neil Warnock and Sheffield United as they get off to the best possible start here at Bramall Lane on day one. 4-1, a scoreline that looked improbable, but it is certainly reality. Eiffel with the pick of the goals, arguably, teed up by Gillespie, and he glanced in beautifully.
3 days later, the Blades were back in action, this time at Turf Moor against Adiak Mbaye's Burnley.
Back with Bromby. Leper gets it against a nice turn. He's got the better of Branch. He looked to put a ball in it. And Shipley has scored. Got to the cross. And Sheffield United have got the lead after just 4 minutes. Burnley were stretched. Good ball in by Webber. And Shipley from what, 4 yards? Easy conversion. And that's the lead for Sheffield United. Throw in, looking for Akinbaye. Akinbaye look to try and turn over a kick. Acrobatic stuff onto the roof of the net. Worth a try. He's holding off his man neatly. Tries of Addy. That was a good overhead kick. Bromby again involved. Oh, it's a nice turn from Webber. He's got a bit of class. Picks out Eiffel. Eiffel trying to get across it. Good challenge from Graham Branch, but he's conceded a corner. Sheffield United's first of the game. For some reason, Paddy Kenny goes into the centre circle for corners. Trying to gee the rest of his team up. Burnley will keep Wade Elliott up. But here it is, a corner to Sheffield United. Morgan's up. Bromby's in there. It's aimed towards Bromby. Sinclair can't win the header. Burnley needs to get it away. Punch on, he's gone in. It's a real scramble in there. It's a real scramble. Webber's claiming it. Punch away from Jensen. Came back in, maybe even off his own man. And it crept in. Maybe Webber got a touch on the line. But it was a very, very soft goal on 40 minutes. Webber looks like he's claiming it. The first corner of the game. And a real scrappy goal. Fielded by Carl Lafferty, just warming up on that far side. But I'm surprised to see him on shortly. This time Sinclair doesn't get the range with the throw. He's going to get the ball back here, though, from Mike Hyde. What's a lovely ball from Mike Hyde. Sinclair getting to the byline. Can he whip it back in? Does. Touch for Gifton. No, Williams. It's in. And it's Addy Akinbaye with the touch. Burnley back in the game. Lovely move. Super ball from Mike Hyde. There was Frank Sinclair. Whipped it back in. Gifton. No, Williams. Helped it on. Addy Akinbaye wasn't going to miss from that range. High into the roof of the net. Burnley back in it. It's Burnley 1, Sheffield United 2.
You know, they said that Burnley's physical. I just thought they played the game well. I thought we did. And I thought the both sets of fans enjoyed it, me tonight. And the referee and linesman were superb.
Excellent. Thanks, Neil.
You'll cut that bit out.
I probably will, yeah. I will. By the referee.
If you left it in now, they'll like that bit. Yeah, they'll like that.
The first defeat of the season followed. Queen's Park Rangers stopped United with goals in the 56th minute from Mark Burcham and in the 90th minute from Stephen Moore. Stephen Cabber pulled one back for the Blades with this consolation. It was back to winning ways the following week against playoff hopefuls Preston.
Still going, Montgomery. Shipley! Just over from Neil Shipley. Oh! Preston in front. McKenna with the goal 10 minutes before the break. Bromby, it's longer this time. Shipley, oh! 1-1. The dying seconds of the first half, and Neil Shipley has equalised. Preston's goal was good. This was something special. He's out of his area to clear. Good shot. Free kick. A little bit more than that. The defender is in some trouble. Yes, it's a yellow card. Last gasp for Sheffield United. Can they find a winner? Well, they can! Webber has got it in the third minute of stoppage time. What an ending to this game.
Next, a Coca-Cola Cup win over Boston United. The goal coming from talented youngster Ian Ross, who was later to join the Pilgrims on loan. Neil Warnock entered into the transfer market, signing experienced Premiership defender David Unsworth. He made his home debut against Coventry City.
Scowcroft with the turn. Scowcroft on a run. Now he's got in behind the defence here. Coventry in front. And just as they had to in their last home game, Sheffield United have to come from behind if they're to get anything from this match. Michael battling for the ball. Cabot. It's an excellent opportunity. It's a goal. The Blades only behind for 4 minutes. Superb strike from Stephen Cabot. Doesn't he like it? his head well, a composed finish. Look at the desperate challenge that the Coventry defender puts in. Gabba makes it 1-1. Quinn, Duffy with the challenge, penalty. Sheffield United scored late in their last home match against Preston, and they have the opportunity to score late in this game against Coventry. David Unsworth. It's 2-1, the 89th minute. Three championship matches so far at home, and three wins.
On a festive bank holiday Monday, United saw out the busy month of August in style with a tremendous away performance against Crewe.
And Neil Shipperley makes no mistake, Sheffield United ahead at Cresty Road. Crewe free kick, looped in towards Paddy Kelly, he's missed it, Foster has equalised for Crewe. Uncharacteristic mistake there from the Sheffield United goalkeeper. And Steve Foster presented with a goal on a plate. United looking to win it back in midfield. It's tossed forward. Here's Alan Quinn bearing down on goal. It's Alan Quinn! 2-1 to the Blades. Alan Quinn puts Sheffield United back in the box seat for 3 points. Montgomery. Acres of space here for Sheffield United to work with. Montgomery with a searching cross. Jagielka heading back here towards Stephen Cabba! It's 3-1 for Sheffield United. He rubs his hands with glee, and Sheffield United have 3 vital points in the quest for Premiership football.
After 6 games, United remained unbeaten at home, and with 5 wins out of 6, they were topping the Championship table. September began, like August, with another home match. This time the visitors, Joe Royal's Ipswich.
Little Quinn, who's got a decent shot on him. Came back to Cabba! That's a smashing finish. And for Steve Cabba, it is his 5th goal in 6 championship games this season. He has now scored in his last 4 games, and today he has scored inside 5 minutes. The Blades are as sharp as they've been for months and years. Quinn speculated, and when it came back out off Naylor, Steve Cabba accumulated. And at the moment, nothing can go wrong for Neil Warnock. Bodic. It's a neat ball in, and Peters was close to getting in front of his centre-half. It came down for Curry. It was stolen away by Sito and was taken from him by Cabba, against whom a penalty is awarded. Paddy Kenny is the first to make Sheffield United's case. Sito is the first to celebrate his earning of the spot kick. All amid much confusion of limbs and ankles and a bobbling ball. To say my first reaction is that Steve Cabba is a shade unlucky there. Perhaps he left a boot in, but it is to be Darren Curry on the ground where his uncle Tony was perhaps the Sheffield United legend. It's Curry, comfortably saved by Kenny. It was a tame effort. And there are plenty in this ground saying justice is done. Forward now, and Sheffield United have 4 players forward, amongst whom here is Steve Cabba. It's Cabba with pace, and the finish, and the points.
Next came a hard-fought win at Brighton, with Phil Jagielka getting off the mark.
Helped on its way towards Shipley, and here's Jagielka. Looks for a give and go with Stephen Cabba. Jagielka saved the first one. Jagielka again!
Neil Warnock's delighted with his side's start to the season.
Difficult to stop a runaway train. It was just like that. You know, we had a bit of fortune in one or two games. I remember going to Watford, playing very well at Watford, but then all of a sudden we're 2-0 down. But we came back, showed a lot of, you know, I think surprised Watford by the way we came back and snatched the 3-2 victory.
McNamee's corner, and Carlisle is up, and Henderson, it's in! Darius Henderson, the scorer. Credit Carlisle for the assist. And Henderson at the bar post gives Watford the lead. Henderson might make this interesting still, and does make it interesting. It's 2-0 at Watford, and it's a disaster for the Sheffield United back line. But Kai got an important touch, it wasn't a clean one. And in the end, Unsworth wanted to hit it, and Quinn decided to go with it. It's gone across now for Kozluk. The header is a very good goal, and it's been scored by Bill Jagielka for Sheffield United. It didn't seem as though there was anything on when Quinn, I have to say, I thought had done the wrong thing. Kozluk's ball back in, Jagielka firm header past Boster, and suddenly the game really is on. Listen, made a hash of it. It was Montgomery's ball for Eiffel. Sheffield United now try and turn the screw, and 2-2 is the score. Eiffel, let's fly, and United are on level terms with 2 in 10 minutes. And Weber is onside, Doyley away. They're queuing up for it here, and it'll come for Eiffel, and in the end it's gone in his own net of Clark Carlisle, and Sheffield United are 3-2 in front.
I don't think there's one particular moment. I think maybe about my header at Watford that, you know, got the game sort of turned around would probably be my own personal best goal, you know, great ball from Coz, but other than that I think it's just been a fantastic season. It'd be hard to pick out one particular game.
The Blades progressed to the third round of the Carling Cup, where United's young guns won a dramatic penalty shootout at Shrewsbury Town. Then they were back in league action against Derby County.
Unsworth's corner in front of the cup. All the way across and all the way in from David Unsworth. Terrible marking from Derby County, but Sheffield United in front, courtesy of David Unsworth. Corner again, deeper this time towards Shipley. Good header back, keeper missed it. Morgan in there, Cabba there too. Morgan again, and now Eiffel! Paul Eiffel picks his spot. Another calamitous error in the Derby defence, and Paul Eiffel makes absolutely sure from 8 yards out. Sheffield United's players were queuing up in the middle, and when it mattered, Paul Eiffel stuck it away. Free kick. United struggling to get hold of the ball here, and this is a surging run down the Derby County left. Paul Pescas leader makes the run in near post, and here he is, and he's scored for Derby County, as he usually does. Paul Pescas leader comes back to haunt Sheffield United and give them a lifeline.
That Derby County victory made it 7 consecutive league wins, a new club record. And the Blades played out September with another classy performance.
In towards Shipley. No! Oh yes! How unfortunate for Lario, the French goalkeeper. Neil Shipley receives the congratulations, but did he make the final touch? No doubt about the touch there from Unsworth. Magnificent crossfield ball. Shipley gets the header, and the goalkeeper hooks it into his own net. Neil Shipley will no doubt claim the goal though. Jagielka finds Quinn. Oh, he's brought down. It's outside the area, no doubt about that. But will it be yellow or red for Barnes? Looked as though he was quite the last man. To strike it, and how? It was a foul on Quinn that led to the free kick. Excellent strike. Sheffield United doubled their lead.
At the end of September, having played 11 games, United were still firmly on top of the table on 30 points. Newly promoted Luton were in third, but heading the chasing pack were the dangerous Reading in second.
Personally, we were slightly better than Reading, and I thought they'd, you know, they'd have a job on to keep up with us. Shows you what a predictor I am. But you know, I think we played them twice. Definitely the game at Reading, we were outstanding at Reading, and as you know, I got into trouble that day, but. You know, I've never ever seen a penalty like that disallowed at 82 minutes. You know, we'd have gone on and won the game, and in the end, we lost a vital game in the last minute, and disappointing, really, that, because we played so well.
Oh, and he was unmarked! And Reading have the lead inside 2 minutes. Brynjar Gunnarsson's first goal for the club. Neil Warnock's men have been beaten only once all season, but they're behind here in no time at all. Eiffel, a Barbadian international. Did well to get the cross in, did very well. Here's Alan Quinn. Kaba! Steve Kaba's name will appear in the papers, but it's Paul Eiffel's name that should be up in lights. It was a fantastic piece of wing play to get the cross in, fed back by Alan Quinn, and Steve Kaba, who used to play for Steve Coppell at Crystal Palace, heads Sheffield United level. With Paul Eiffel, you know what you're getting. A reliable, old-fashioned, there's nothing demeaning about that, old-fashioned winger. His cross set up the opportunity for Kaba to score. 1-1, game on. Concentrating on the game this time. Gillespie. Oh! Was that a foul? Looked suspiciously like it. James Harper came careering in and just seemed to take Keith Gillespie out. It's a look of disbelief. Knocked the ball away from him and then back inside the area. Four 6 foot plus players in there. Oh, good header, it's in. Reading have got it. Brynjar Gunnarsson with his second goal of the afternoon, and we're in the 89th minute. The goalkeeper, who is lucky to be out there, beaten by the most delicate of glancing headers from the Icelander. Too much for Sheffield United to do now. It's all over and Reading have won.
After a 2 week break, United bounced straight back against highly fancied Wolves.
Morgan's up from the back. Jagielka and Shipley wait on the edge of the box. Swept in towards Morgan, looping in towards Shipley! Neil Shipley squeezes the ball in. Although Stephen Kaba tries to take credit, it will be Neil Shipley's goal, that's for sure.
A class performance away to Millwall and a first start for on-loan striker Vincent Perricard.
Millwall had the opportunity to clear, but Perricard made amends. Tong from Jagielka's ball, and now Danny Webber, chance to stretch those legs, and Webber! Oh, what a goal! Danny Webber absolutely thundered the ball in from the edge of the box. We didn't see that coming, and neither did the Millwall goalkeeper. What a hit! Sheffield's free kick. Into with Perricard. Now Geary. Supporting here is Montgomery. Cross is blocked, but he has won a Sheffield United corner. And possibilities again here for Sheffield United to test the Millwall goalkeeper. It's Unsworth's corner. Again, it's dangerous. Swept in towards the far post. Perricard notches his first goal for Sheffield United, arriving unmarked, and that's what it means to him. Is it long here? Perricard goes down on the edge of the box. It will be a free kick in a fantastic position. And Sheffield United's dominance in this game continues. Millwall just cannot get a grip here. It's going to be Alan Quinn. Tong moves away. It's Alan Quinn! Oh, what a finish! And a night of great finishes. Alan Quinn adds his name to the score sheet. What a free kick. Straight around the wall, and the goalkeeper absolutely no chance. There's Tong to steal the ball back, and Alan Quinn has released Danny Webber away down the left-hand side here, looking up for options, or will he go alone? Jinks his way into the penalty area, so dangerous in these positions, and he's bent it in as well, and Sheffield United have a fourth. Smiles all around as Sheffield United celebrate their biggest win of the season so far.
A great result then for the Blades, and Danny Webber's delighted to have contributed.
Every time I get the ball, I'm always sort of looking to where the goal is. It just seems that I think because we play with, generally we play with a lot of width on the right, but our left-hand players generally come in, so there's always a lot of space on the left-hand side, so I generally just drift out there to pick the ball up. I don't really go into any game looking at it any different, thinking we're home or away from home. The way I see it is, you know, you're on a football pitch, you play, you know, it doesn't matter where you are. I play the same way I would play anywhere, really.
Friday night action followed, with the Blades in a confident mood away to Leeds United. The torrential rain couldn't dampen the atmosphere.
Well, Sheffield United did the double over Leeds last season, including a 4-0 win here. There are scores to settle for the men of Elland Road. The rain has been falling heavily since mid-afternoon. Just what you want for a Yorkshire derby. It all adds to the occasion. Jagielka, some try, some power on it. It's a shove. Butler on cover. Cabba let it go for Shipley, who returns it. Stephen Cabba forced away by Sullivan.
Fantastic play. What an over that is. Superb stuff. That's where Shipley comes into his own. And this fella, produced the goods along with him.
Fraser Richardson. Blake's cross. It might come to Hulse. Oh, what a chance for Leeds and for their top scorer.
Oh, how has he scored? How has he not scored in this particular instance? Watch Robbie Blake, he's given too much time, Robbie Blake. Stop the cross. That's what Neil Warnock was saying to Quinn. Never mind standing away from him, just stop that cross. Once it comes off Alan Wright's head and ends up on Rob Hulse's head, I cannot believe he has not turned his head sideways to pop that in the corner of the net. Look at Blackie, he thinks it's in. He's just about to celebrate. I can't believe it.
What can he? Derry, Robbie Blake, it opens up. And Blake finds Richardson. Can he get his shot away? You bet he can! A stunner from Richardson. And Leeds strike first in this Yorkshire derby. Alan Quinn making the most of it. And Gary Kelly hasn't got it away. It's Webber. And it's Stephen Cabba, and it's 1-1, and that is typical of Sheffield United. They have responded. Cabba with the equaliser.
Ah, brilliant strike from Steve Cabba. It was always going in from the minute he left his boot, but Gary Kelly, he's out-muscled by Alan Quinn. Just get rid of it, Gary. That's what Kevin Blackwell will say to him afterwards. After then, they get a little bit of luck there when Weber gives it to Cabba, but after that, once he gets it on that right foot to drag it away from the goalkeeper with the direction that he does, the two defenders shield the ball almost, and Sullivan in the goal can only stretch out that arm, but can he get it? Not a chance. What a goal, and there he is. Look, he told the fans there was still time.
And do you had your bit of fun with the Leeds crowd?
Well, yeah, I mean, let's be fair. The fourth official, the crowd shouted 1-1 at what's the score. So I put one finger up and zero. But then I said, but there's plenty of time left. And 4 or 5 minutes later, the fourth official comes to me and says to me, the security man says, if you incite the crowd anymore, I'll have to remove you. Have they got a joke or what? I mean, the crowd loved it. You know, I had a good patter with the crowd. There's no fun left in the game, is it? It's, you know, security man. Well.
The following week, a young United side were put out of the Carling Cup by close rivals Reading. Then at the end of October, the unbeaten run came to an end. It was with a goalless draw against Cameron Jerome's Cardiff City. The gap between Sheffield United and second place Reading began to close, whilst third place Luton still trailed the leaders by 10 points.
Cabot. Just looking for support there from Quinn. United get the throw and Quinn restarts proceedings quickly. Cabot wanted a free kick and gets it. Marlon Beresford's goal under pressure. The goalkeeper's punched it away. Morgan, oh, in by Jackie Elka. It was returned so swiftly into the six-yard area. Hit Morgan, and Jagielka stabbed it in. Eiffel was having a shirt tug there. Whistle has gone eventually. Luke penalised. Quinn with the free kick. It's Chris Morgan. It's 2-0. The captain on target to double Sheffield United's lead. Sam Perricard is coming on, placing Shipley up front. Kept in play by Eiffel. Cabot. Geary's making a good run down this near side. Here is Derek Geary. Perricard! The substitute seals the win for Sheffield United. Geary was injured in putting that ball in. Wonderful cross. And Perricard stabbing the ball home. Sheffield United comfortable. Weber. He's done well to win it back, Danny Weber. Weber still looking to retrieve the ball back for his side, which he's done successfully. Clearance by Kenny. And here to Jagielka. This is Weber. Jagielka's continued his run. It's Jagielka! That seals it. 4-0 to Sheffield United.
I remember going to Palace, difficult place, and played some great football at Palace, and we won again there, scoring three goals.
Cabba, neat turn, neat feet. Stephen Cabba, and he's pulled it back for Jagielka, who's hit the post, and Shipley watches it in. Phil Jagielka. Two goals in the week and one at the weekend, and Sheffield United, having had their woodwork struck moments previously, have established a lead via the woodwork. Beautiful penetration from Cabba. It was he who made it possible. Jagielka who guided it goalwards,
And by the time Shipley arrived, the ball had already comfortably nestled. Splendid work from Cabot. And precision from Jagielka. Three in the week for him. And the Blades have another lead. Morrison. Right. Hughes! 1-1! Quinn bursting through. Shipley ahead of him. Cabot wide. Hall away. Quinn gets a second bite at it. Here comes Jagielka. Been a really thrilling first half, this. Jagielka to run at Hall. And to play it for Eiffel! Back ahead in the blinking of an eye, the Championship leaders. And Paul Eiffel, the former Millwall player back in South London, has South Yorkshire's finest back in front at Selhurst. The indignity of conceding one too much for Sheffield United, who expect to be ahead these days, and who are ahead, courtesy of Paul Eiffel's left boot. Answorth with the set piece. And with whip, and Kirai went down and did it cross the line. Assistant says yes, goal given. And Kirai is incandescent. The downward header went between the goalkeeper's legs, and the suggestion is the ball might just have crossed the line.
Skipper Chris Morgan's really happy with the way that the side bonded.
You know, we stick together, and I like it at times this year where, you know, we haven't been playing so well, but then we've done other side. We thought, well, hold on a minute, let's roll our sleeves up and let's dig in, and we've done it. And you know, I think we've got massive results through doing that this year. You know, we've got great results where we've played well and played good football, and everybody's like, "Wait, aren't they playing well?" But I think as players, you appreciate sometimes the other bit where, yeah, you're not playing well, but you know what a great result that is away from home.
United continued with a feisty draw against Millwall.
Again. This is Quinn. Finds Montgomery. Might have a go here, Montgomery. Oh! It was so close to going in from Pedicard. Cabot. Nice turn. Finds Paul Eiffel. Former Millwall player. Eiffel goes for goal. Well, it's got a deflection, it's a corner kick. Taken short. Flicked on to Unsworth, who scores. David Unsworth was injured in the active shooting, but he won't mind too much about that. 5 minutes played and Sheffield United are in front. Unsworth on target. Some considerable cost though. Towards the edge of the penalty area. Oh, that's a complete miss kick. Dyer, he's in behind the United defence and he's scored. And it's 1-1. Eiffel. It's Quinn. That's a good save from Jones. Hales. Makes the run into the area. Dyer, 2-1. Two goals to Bruce Dyer. And Millwall, bottom of the table coming into this match, are in front. Jagielka off the bar. Couldn't be turned in by Weber. He has a little bit of space on this near side.
Goes for the byline, Keith Gillespie gets his cross in. Quinn, Webber, 2-2. Well into stoppage time at Bramall Lane. Hales with the header. Kenny's out to clear. Oh, little bit of afters there between Hales and Morgan. And Morgan, well, what's going on here? Hales in particular is livid. Chris Morgan was at the centre of all that. Mark Klattenberg pulling the United captain towards him. Well, it's going to be a card. And it is a red card. Chris Morgan is sent off.
Sometimes he wants to win too much, and that's what lets him down. His head goes a few minutes, but who am I to say anything about the heads going for a few minutes?
You know, end of day, things have happened, and, you know, sending off some blah, 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 and he'll have a go at you, but end of day, he'll do it in the right manner.
He's a great ambassador, you know, off the field, he organises things, and is a leader, he wants to win.
You know, once he's told you something, if you take it in, then you carry on playing. If you don't, then, you know, he'll show you where the door is and he'll bring somebody else in who will do a job for him.
United earned another precious point with a 0-0 draw against Wolves to keep the Blades on top. With the media storm brewing about a possible move to Portsmouth for Neil Warnock, the Blades lost 4-2 away at Leicester City, bringing United's 8-game unbeaten run to a halt. The Blades also lost top spot to Reading. It was a worrying time for United. In the week following, Pompey made that approach official. But just 2 days before the big one against Wednesday, the manager announced that he's staying put and immediately tried to focus on United's most important game of the season to date.
Derby games are always special, home and away. But it was on my birthday, Sheffield Wednesday at home. And of course, after the Portsmouth connection with myself, it was just glad to get back on the touchline and against our rivals and get another victory under our belt.
Derbies divide families and throw up special challenges for some players. Lee Bromby and Alan Quinn, discarded by Wednesday last year, today become the first men since World War II to play for both clubs in the derby. David Unsworth and Craig Short, veterans of many a Merseyside skirmish, are back from injury. Neil Shipperley and Steve Cabba also return. Wednesday haven't won here since 1967. They give a debut to Peter Gilbert at left back. The former Liverpool winger Richie Partridge is chosen ahead of Chris Eagles. And they include the only Sheffield-born player on view, on loan goalkeeper Nicky Weaver, a lifelong Owl. Back from the brink of a messy divorce, now for the renewal of vows. No club has a bigger fan as manager than Sheffield United under Neil Warnock. The 117th Steel City Derby, United 42 wins, Wednesday 37. A mixed reception for Lee Bromby as a former Wednesday player. Craig Short is forward, there's Partridge for Wednesday. Shipperley was up early. And here's Danny Webber. And Webber to Cabba! Should have scored. He made no sort of contact at all. It leapt up and hit his hand in the end. It's a gift of a chance for Steve Cabba. Now on the ball again. Trying to get past Coughlin. The referee says no foul. And it's just the sort of high-octane start that you expect on an occasion like this. Graham for Partridge. Murphy only loosely marked. And behind by Robbie Kozlik. Well, if United don't win today, this will haunt Steve Cabot. Four in the box for Chris Brunt. Pumped downfield. Looks to release Cabot, and Cabot's in there! And he has missed again. And he was set up by the quick thinking of his own goalkeeper. The punt downfield by Paddy Kenny caught out the entire Sheffield Wednesday defence. And it just needed more by way of sureness of touch from Steve Cabot. He would have got the assist. And he, at the moment, is taking the blame. Howard Wilkinson, the centre of your picture, was a very successful Sheffield Wednesday manager, of course, but what Dickie Bird's doing here, I can't fathom. He's from Barnsley. Nothing to do with him. Pass the ball off Whelan. Players already blowing hard. Weather. Wood. Coslick. Alan Quinn. Steve Cabot. This is nice. Here's Cabot. And Shipperley. And Quinn! It's in! Alan Quinn makes history. The first player ever to score for both Sheffield clubs in the derby. This fixture still setting firsts after 113 years. Cute build-up. Shipley had the first chance, and then Quinn, with the aid of a deflection, buried it. In the last derby here, he scored for Wednesday. Now he's done it for United, and nobody has ever achieved that before. In by Unsworth. Oh, referee's whistle goes, which is a huge relief to a goalkeeper who was nearly left red-faced. Rocastle. Sheffield Wednesday sensing something and very nearly getting something through Murphy. Cabot. Montgomery. Coslett goes down, nothing doing, says Richard Beebe. And only now is Robbie Coslett picking himself up. Craig Rocastle made the tackle. It's been fairly attritional stuff in the first half of the second half. Shipperley. Quinn. Cabot, Coslett, Shipperley! Well, there were any number of Sheffield United chances in the first half. There have not been many in the second. Weaver was far enough off his line for Shipperley to hope. Eagles, Shimmick, second chance for Chris Eagles, and a third, Whelan, he can strike it, so can Burton O'Brien! Well, Sheffield United have had enough warnings now. Tom, straight out of play, 30 seconds left. Has to be some urgency here from Sheffield Wednesday. Referee has checked his watch, not for the first time. Sheffield is a red and white city tonight. A difficult week for Sheffield United, and their manager ends with a return to winning ways. Alan Quinn's moment of history ensured that. Wednesday had the better of the second half, but the bragging rights are United's. At least until these teams next collide at the end of February.
A well-deserved victory for the Blades, and the manager had a word or two of praise for summer signing Craig Short.
You know, I know that was the most crucial signing for me last summer, was getting him to shake my hand before anybody else offered him more money. Because I knew once he shook my hand, he was the type of a lad that you want for your own son, you know. and it would never renege on a shaking hand, would Craig, because his family aren't like that.
I know what he's like as a manager. I've played for him before, so, you know, apart from most of the season, well, especially up till Christmas, getting injuries, I was getting a little bit frustrated, but he knew I wasn't going to be able to contribute for, you know, all the games, but, you know, I felt as though I contributed some of the games. And
with the transfer window due to open at the end of the month, United continue to be linked with a move for Adeyake Mbaye as he arrived with his Burnley.
And Burnley can sweep it long. Here's Adeyake Mbaye into the box. Akinbaye, good save, Kenny, as well. Down low to his left, and Adeyake Mbaye can't quite believe it. Montgomery, and now Quinn, looking for options. He's found one in Shipley, who was tackled, but then United get it moving again. Coslett, and now Montgomery. Montgomery waiting for support here. He's got options with Quinn. Quinn trying to find Webber. He's got free here, Danny Webber as well. Looking for Shipley. Neil Shipley! Oh, what about that, Neil Shipley? What a hit from the edge of the box. Webber helped him out as well, but Neil Shipley used his body strength and powered the ball in past the goalkeeper. Wins corner, carried away, picked up here by Armstrong, who drilled the ball in, but Burnley get it clear. Coslett, finding Montgomery, who's had a great game so far. Played down the line here for Bromby. Montgomery's cross is a searching ball, far post, glance towards Danny Webber! Well, he just can't miss from there, can he? Craig Short nodding the ball across, and Danny Webber with the simple task of nodding the ball in. Great leap from Short, and Webber will certainly not miss from there. Short looking to get the ball clear here for Sheffield United. Here's Coslett, floated in towards Webber. Neat flick for Jagielka, who's done really well here. United breaking with purpose. This is Armstrong. This is developing into a terrific move. Armstrong's cross in towards Neil Shipley. Oh, what a finish that is. Fantasy football at Bramall Lane as Neil Shipley cracks it home. Set up brilliantly by Chris Armstrong's overlapping run. And Neil Shipley, one touch to control, then bam, back of the net.
Yeah, I thought that was probably as good as we've played this season, because make no mistake, they're not a bad side, Burnley. They've had a great run of late. But we scored some good goals at important times, played some cracking football. And, you know, we've had a little bit of an upside-down week. We've had one, two or three injuries coming late in the week, you know, to Cabber and Gillespie and Eiffel. But we've overcome that today, and the squad's shown through today, and you know, I think we've done well.
United shared the spoils with a 0-0 draw at Preston. That result left Warnock happy with the Blades' progress ahead of a busy Christmas period.
I think before the season started, I said to the players, if we can be there or thereabouts, the top two, you know, within a touching distance, sort of at when we play Sheffield Wednesday, I'd be delighted with the start, you know, and we've surpassed that really, you know, by being 10 points in front of the third club. As we come up to that busy period, it's a fantastic achievement by the lads, and thoroughly deserved, I think, over the whole season.
It was a big blow for an expectant Boxing Day crowd next, when despite Jagielka's early goal, United suffered their first home defeat of the campaign against Norwich.
And we gave three silly goals away, and if you do that, you're going to lose any game, whatever standard. So, you know, you could see with the celebrations at the end, they thought they won the Champions League today.
With snow causing havoc on the roads, United were away at Southampton, and they quickly bounced back to winning ways. Webber and Shipley, that partnership proved to be lethal again. They linked up to give United all 3 points. The final game of the year was at home to Stoke, and the Blades dug deep to take three more valuable points.
For Shipley, as well, to knock it out to Webber. Possibilities here for Sheffield United. It's Danny Webber, good save by the goalkeeper, positioned himself well. Unsworth's free kick, swept in, it's a dangerous one, it's bubbling around all over the place. Morgan's in there trying to hold off the challenge. Knocked back towards Jagielka, and now teed up for Montgomery. He's done really well. He's found the bottom corner, and Nick Montgomery scores for Sheffield United. Stoke looking to alter the scoreline here with a surging move. They've done well, and Sheffield United need to try and win the ball. problems here as the ball is struck into the box. Mamadi Sidibe, 1-1. United on the defensive again, desperately trying to win back this ball as it's tossed high into the box. Sidibe missed his header, but still Stoke keep coming. Here's Daryl Russell into the penalty area. It's Russell, good save by the goalkeeper. Paddy Kenny stretched himself when it mattered, and Daryl Russell can't believe he's not scored. Coslett with a raking ball forward. Webber peeling off, half cleared away. Tong is there to try and wrestle back for the ball. Tong has won it back, in towards Neil Shipley. Jagielka keeps it moving, looks to cross far post. Not a bad one, Morgan! Chris Morgan puts Sheffield United back ahead. Oh, what a finish that was from the Sheffield United captain. Jagielka's ball in, and Chris Morgan with a thumping header past the goalkeeper in front of the cup. Stoke corner for Sheffield United to deal with. It's bubbling around and stopped on the line by Derek Geary, and quite rightly gets a pat on the back from the goalkeeper Paddy Kenny.
I can't speak highly enough. We've had, you know, three tough games, another one to come on Tuesday, but massive win for us. Psychologically, it's a great win for us because, you know, 94th minute, a lot of clubs behind us would have been hoping for a slip up, and we've come through, and it's a marvellous result.
With the title race shaping up, United trail leaders Reading by 7 points, but crucially lead third place Leeds by 11. January began with a memorable trip to Hull City.
Here's Jason Price! Oh, what about that from Jason Price? What a strike! Here's Armstrong looking to dribble his way forward, stopped in his tracks though, but he has found David Unsworth. Touched off here by Shipley for Eiffel, twisting and turning, took an awkward deflection and he's gone all the way in. Bo Myhill can't believe it, but Paul Eiffel celebrates at the KC Stadium. All clear. Flicked on, Morgan missed his header. Here's Jason Price. Still Price, Unsworth with an aggressive tackle. The referee waves play on as Unsworth searches out Danny Webber. Possibilities here for United. Webber's so dangerous in these sorts of positions. Finds a little gap and finds the corner. Danny Webber gets his 7th goal of the season with a fantastic goal. Danny Webber warms Sheffield United's hearts on a chilly, chilly night here at the KC Stadium. What about that for a finish? Webber again looking menacing every time he gets the ball. So too Michael Tong, back in the lineup tonight, of course. Armstrong for Jagielka as Sheffield United switch the play. Unsworth can send it long now. The target is Neil Shipley, does well to knock it down. Armstrong levers it on towards Danny Webber, chasing this ball down. He's under pressure though. United still with the ball here, toying with Hull City. Webber waiting for options, has one now in Armstrong. Armstrong darts his way to the penalty area and scores! Sheffield United 3-1 ahead at the KC Stadium. Great vision from Danny Webber, but note the run from Chris Armstrong, and he's done well, really well, to tuck that in the far corner.
The Blades have enjoyed many good cup runs, but not this year. They were dumped out of the FA Cup in the third round. That was after a shock defeat to League One visitors Colchester. 7 days later, United were in action against Ipswich.
And Sheffield United at the moment chasing shadows as it's hit long. Geary will head away, but not too convincing. Morgan looks to get it away, and Jagielka with his foot raised, he caught himself a little bit unlucky there. And Ipswich will get a free kick in a very dangerous position. It's Jimmy Kwan over the wall, and a fantastic free kick. Paddy Kenny could do nothing about that, and what a strike from the Spaniard. United trailing and looking to claw themselves back into this game. Here's Michael Tong with a menacing run. That is a delicious pass for Danny Webber round the goalkeeper. Two defenders ahead of Webber here, but he's beaten them both and he's put it away for Sheffield United to equalise. Yet again, it's that man, Danny Webber, a real moment of magic, his 8th goal of the season. With Danny Webber now injured, what will they do without him? Ipswich swing the ball into the box.
And Paddy Kenny gets rid of it quickly. And Stephen Cabba is in pursuit of this. And Stephen Cabba could be in the clear here. Stephen Cabba, we know, has got pace, but he hasn't got the finish this time. Oh, what a glorious chance for Stephen Cabba to wrap up the win.
Next up, relegation candidates Brighton.
Unsworth in space on the left. Overlapping here is Armstrong. Chance to cross here. But he's made a move into the box. He does sweep it in now towards Jagielka. First time shot. The goalkeeper didn't even see it. And Phil Jagielka rifles Sheffield United into an early lead.
Bromby.
With Cabba. Beaten to it that time. And then sent back towards the goalkeeper. And Brighton hope to get themselves clear. But Paul Eiffel has robbed them. Eiffel into the box here. It's Paul Eiffel! Sheffield United, two goals to the good. What a strike from Paul Eiffel. Just lifted it over the goalkeeper. And Sheffield United in a commanding position at Bramall Lane.
Brighton hopping and puffing, but at the moment not managing to find a way through as Eiffel clears away to Cabba. Cabba spots the run of Michael Tong, and Brighton in all kinds of problems. It's Michael Tong for Sheffield United to wrap it up, and he has. Michael Tong delighted with that goal, quite rightly so as well. He's been an integral part since returning to the side, and Sheffield United in a commanding position. It's already been a legendary season at Bramall Lane, and a Sheffield United legend makes his entrance. Brian Dean comes on for Sheffield United.
Missed it, and it's helped on its way towards Colin Kazim Richards here, and that is a terrific strike, bottom corner, to give Brighton a little bit of hope, but it's too little too late, surely.
Brighton looking for a second, short away. Tom finds Eiffel. Eiffel with a chance to spread the play. There's Alan Quinn now galloping forward, and Brian Dean's made a run into the box. Brian Dean! Good save by the goalkeeper! What a story that would have been for Brian Dean. Everybody in the crowd willing him to score, but on that occasion thwarted by a top draw save.
Yeah, outstanding. And I was pleased for Eiffel and Tong because they've both worked very, very hard. And sometimes it's a bit hard and frustrating for the crowds, you know, if the wingers don't do everything they want. But I said to Paul at half-time, Paul Eiffel, just be patient and don't worry about the crowd, you know. It's more difficult to create opportunities like Paul does than to be a centre-half or a full-back or a dogged midfield player. I was a winger, so I know how difficult it is, and it comes up with a gem of a goal.
There were just three league games in January, but United had earned another precious 7 points towards promotion. Ahead of the game against Derby, the manager finally got his man. Adiaki Mbaye arrived from Burnley for a club record £1.75 million.
Smith, always lively, good cross, played out by Unsworth. Here's Idiakes, there's a man over as well on the right-hand side, if he can find him. Problems here for the Blades. The cross is handled by Unsworth, it'll be a penalty kick. Derby have a route into this game and have a chance to take an early lead here. Well, Sheffield United's players protest, but to no avail, the penalty kick will stand, and David Unsworth adjudged to have used his hand. Paddy Kenny, can he save it? Yes, he can. Good save from Tommy Smith, although the penalty wasn't the greatest, but when it mattered, Paddy Kenny came to Sheffield United's rescue. Eiffel's cross, Akinbaye! On his debut, what a start to his Sheffield United career. It's Adi Akinbaye who gives Sheffield United the lead. Eiffel's cross was immaculate, but Adi Akinbaye glances the ball in 6 yards out and puts his name in red and white lights.
Monday night misery followed as Watford cut the gap to 11 points. United were already a goal down when David Unsworth was shown a red card for an incident involving the former Owl, Chris Eagles. Reduced to 10 men, it's a handicap too great for the Blaze to overcome, despite a second half goal from Paul Eiffel.
Well,
After a dull 0-0 draw at Plymouth, league leaders Reading are the visitors for a midweek table-topping clash.
He drills the cross to the edge of the box. Might break towards Bruce Dyer! It's there! Sheffield United ahead in the battle of the Championship heavyweights! It's Bruce Dyer! What a start to his Sheffield United career! Brumby's cross bubbled around and Bruce Dyer in there where it mattered to stick it away. There's Murty. Beyond Eiffel. And beyond Michael Tom, he's got Condi out to the left. Here is the American. Blue and white shirts making a run for him. Kitson! 1-1! The faintest of flicks. Paddy Kenny furious, but Dave Kitson absolutely overjoyed. Tom's corner. Swept in far post. Jagielka's header. Cabba's in there. Stopped on the line twice by Little. And then Hanneman smothers the ball and clings onto it for dear life. How on earth did that stay out? Great free kick. Armstrong thought about it. Michael Tom will sweep it in. Bounces beyond Akinbaye. Cabba! Oh, what a miss! Marcus Hanneman sticks out his left leg, but Stephen Cabba knows he should have scored. Morgan leaping. Pitcroft in there. Picks him with a chance to clear Reading's lines. Break here towards Convey. He's in the clear down the left. Armstrong chasing back with him, but Convey holds him off. And Paddy Kenny comes out, makes a great save, and then Convey goes down, looking in vain for a penalty, which he's going to get as well. And Reading have a great chance here to take all 3 points. It's Kitson against Kenny, and Kenny saves it. What a stop down low to his left. Dave Kitson knows he should have finished that, but it stays all square at Bramall Lane. What a save by the Sheffield United goalkeeper.
I thought two very good teams tonight. I thought we were the better team tonight. I thought we were the better team at Reading as well, but unfortunately we're not in their position in the league table.
The Sheffield derby began with a minute's silence for two Sheffield Wednesday fans who were tragically killed. It was immaculately observed by all.
It's the 248th derby meeting, the 106th in league games. Of course, there have been many others in different cup competitions, wartime matches. Paddy Kenny, the goalkeeper, who saved that penalty against Reading the other night and who recently signed a contract taking him up to 2008 at Bramall Lane. That was welcome. One of the longest-serving managers in the game, really. You know, it's over 6 years since he took over at Bramall Lane. Adamson stays beneath his bar. It's hooked in by Akinbaye, and it's the first save, really, that either goalkeeper's had to make. And it was a routine stop for Chris Adamson. And they've lost it again here to Jagielka. For Dyer now. Wednesday, they're trying to pull them around all about the place, and that's a trip and a free kick, is it? The referee could have allowed play to continue as Armstrong motored on into the area. But Brunt had tripped him. And it's the best option, really, for United. Free kick here. Morgan racing up to get to the back post. Collins coming up too. He's a tall man. He's behind Akinbaye, and Dyer is the other United player in. So there are four in the penalty box to meet this free kick. Tong. Oh, it's a brilliant strike! And United lead! And the signal there is from Michael Tong, who's got only his second goal of the season. It's the one he'll cherish more than any. United lead at Hillsborough. Brilliant strike from Tong. Here it is, all the way beyond Adamson's despairing arms. And it's Wednesday nil, United 1. And the man of the moment is Michael Tong. Tong. Foul, just a good tackle in there from Simic. He's been one of the better Wednesday players. And United have got a move going here, surprisingly maybe. Akinbaye, can he make it two? He certainly can! Right at the final seconds of the first half, United are going delirious here. Ali Akinbaye thrashes the ball into the roof of Adamson's net, into the roof of the Wednesday net. And you can tell from that reaction how much it means to United's new striker.
Wednesday nil, United 2. They were really caught hopping here, and the bounce of the ball, it took it through to Akinbaye, who lashed it beneath the crossbar, and they have a second goal on the stroke of half-time. Indeed, it's probably the last kick of the half as the players are now going off to the dressing room. Jagielka though for United, hits it long. The race is on here for Dyer. Coughlin across and covering, Bullens in the middle along with Simek, Akinbaye in between them though. If Dyer gets the ball in here, it's no, it should have been three. Akinbaye launched himself as the ball fell onto his head virtually 3 yards out, but somehow he's managed to put it amongst the United fans and not into the Wednesday net, otherwise the game was over. He's got to do some work here, Morgan, as well. And they're asking for a penalty, and the referee's given the penalty as well. Well, we're going to have to see this one again. The referee had a close-up view of it. Morgan was the one who was shielding the ball, having just spectacularly headed it away. There's a chance here for Chris Brunt to bring Wednesday into the game. Or it may be McLean. Brunt's handing over the penalty duties, and Wednesday have one back. Steve McLean with his first goal of the season. After three broken legs, he's back to get on the score sheet. Wednesday have a response here. Simic's throw is to Whelan, looping it up. Kenny coming for the punch and getting it, a flailing arm. It's back in towards him. It'll be cleared off the line. It's hacked away off the line by Kozluk, who gets a pat on the head from his keeper. What scenes here at Hillsborough, 33,000 roaring. United want the final whistle. Wednesday want it to carry on. This has to be the last chance for Wednesday. A Brunt free kick, and it's away to Simek. Simek will thrash it through. It comes back off a United man. Paddy Kenny has the ball. It's surely good enough now for United to win the day. They have done. It's all over. And for the second time this season, United take the spoils against their local rivals.
The last game in February brought a shock, a second defeat of the season by Queen's Park Rangers.
Picked by Furlong, and Nygaard's in the clear here, and Chris Morgan desperately trying to get back. It's Nygaard, Kenny comes out, might break for Nygaard again! 1-0 Queen's Park Rangers! The biggest man on the field has given the away side the lead at Bramall Lane. Free kick, Armstrong. He's Michael Tong with a chance to cross as well in towards Adi Akinbaye. It's there.
How on earth did he manage to squeeze that ball in? He was backpedalling as well when he nodded the ball. All square.
Corner, swept to near post.
Own goal, Mark Burcham. Sheffield United ahead.
By Jones, and Morgan tugged back by Evert there, and the referee has given a penalty to Sheffield United, and this topsy-turvy game has taken another twist, and Danny Shittu has been booked amid all of that as well. Paul Eiffel for Sheffield United, chance to score, it's saved by Jones, and then turned in again, and Jones makes the save. Paul Eiffel with a glorious chance wasted. Delivering towards Nygaard, and Morgan has turned the ball in beyond Paddy Kenny, and Queen's Park Rangers are back in it at 2-2. This kick again has been a real live wire, options to his left and right. He's gone left to Furlong, the former Sheffield United loanee, scores against his former club, and Queen's Park Rangers just crawling towards three valuable points at Bramall Lane and looking to do the double over Sheffield United.
So, by the end of the month, Watford and Leeds had cut the gap to 7 and 8 points respectively. Neil Warnock, though, remained philosophical.
The nearer the other teams got to us, you know, your Leeds, your Watford, your Palace, they were all starting to say what they were going to do, and they're all young managers. And I think in life in general, you tend to spout a little bit when you're younger. But I thought if we could turn our own house in, or put our own house in order, it wouldn't take much, and I felt that these managers had never come up against any problems before. They'd had all season had gone well, and it was true to care. You know, it came true.
After a snowy 0-0 home draw against Crewe, United were away at the Ricoh Arena for the first time against Coventry City. They're already 2-0 down by half-time.
I thought half-time at Coventry was a turning point for me. Losing 2-0, and we were very fortunate to be losing 2-0, should have been 5 or 6. And I thought at half-time, when I was just thinking to myself, we could either go down 4 or 5-0 here and that's our season finished, or we can roll our sleeves up, give it our best shot, and then be positive. And that's what we did. We didn't score, we lost 2-0, but we deserved to get some at the second half.
United's wobble looked like it was going to end at Norwich. Chris Armstrong scored an early goal, but he was later cancelled out by first Leon McKenzie, then Robbie Earnshaw. Despite the loss, Neil Warnock remained upbeat.
I found it so difficult to actually be in the press conference after, once again having lost. And I never forget the press conference where they were saying, you know, when they came, asked me about my situation, and I was never more positive. And I really made an effort to be so positive and say how well we'd played and how things had gone well for the last 10 days and we were back now. And I could see one or two of the press guys thinking he's dropped, he's not a full shilling here and one thing or another. But it just shows you that it was right. That feeling was back and the confidence was there.
So with the gap closing and Watford within 3 points of the Blades, the game against Southampton was a real test of nerves, a must-win situation.
Armstrong. Tong. Tong as well to skip past the challenge. He's found Armstrong in the box as well, who kept going. Not a bad cross into the middle. Jagielka! It's a big goal and a big game. And Phil Jagielka sticks the ball in for Sheffield United. Havlicek's throw. In towards Shipley, didn't quite get there, and there's Paul Eiffel! He's scored, and Sheffield United have another goal at the lane. You can feel the relief here now. Paul Eiffel squeezed his way through and just managed to send the goalkeeper the wrong way. Makes it back. Tom wants it. The Blades can sweep the ball to the right there on Kozlov. Gillespie outside him, Kozlov doesn't need him. Still Kozlov, for Jagielka. And now Armstrong. And Jagielka with a chance to cross here. Floated in, back across goal by Gillespie. Weber arriving, it will stay out just off the post. Calamitous there from Southampton, but Neil Shipley profits from the clearance. And Neil Shipley sends a big sigh of relief around Bramall Lane. And the Premiership push is certainly back on track now.
A fantastic result made even better when Watford lost at home and Leeds only managed a draw.
Well, it's not the other results that are going to get us up, that is a cert. It's playing like we've done today and the belief. And I think the team at the moment have got that belief again. We've got that little bit of, I think, a little bit of class in certain areas. And we do the hard work. The hard work is a horrible, nasty thing, but we do that hard work. And a lot of players don't like doing that. But we've done that well today. And obviously, the goals have come on top of that.
Still, obviously, a little way to go. Some important matches, not least Leeds. What's the recipe between now and the end of the season to secure that automatic promotion?
Well, it would be nice to win every game, but knowing us, it will go down to the last game. I think it's always going to be close. There's ups and downs. There's pressure on everywhere now. I mean, you've seen the results today. Who would have expected any of those results, really? And that's what football's about. Football, there is no easy game. There's no game that you can predict. And that's why we all love it so much.
You're talking there about the pressure. What is the pressure like? I'm talking about on you now, when you know that so much depends on getting the results in the next few games, and particularly today.
Well, there's no pressure on me. My contract's up in the summer. What pressure is there? If we don't go up, I'll be sacked probably. So I think today the lads played as I want them to play, with a smile, with a swagger, do the hard work, and I think we've got half a chance when we play like that.
Against Stoke, another precious point was secured thanks to another super solo effort from Danny Webber. Elsewhere, Leeds and Watford both lost. Hull City next at home, and with just 5 games remaining, a win would put promotion within sight.
That's a decent touch by Jagielka to free Tom. Not quite so good for Eiffel. Kozluk outside him. Tong. Shipley! That's the moment! That's what the Blades have been waiting for! And it's that old dreadnought of a striker, an expert in earning promotion, Neil Shipley, who's turned in the cross. Delivered with patience and accuracy by Michael Tong. For the veteran Shipley to do his stuff. They've had their chances, which they've wasted. And now one has been accepted. 9 minutes shy of half-time. Armstrong for Weber. Eiffel is central. And there is Paul Eiffel. And that is 2-0. Applause from every corner of Bramall Lane for the man who, as his celebration tells you, became a father this week. And not just that, but his 300th league game too. The rapier-like thrust led by Weber, and the cross converted by the head of Dad. Paul Eiffel, Sheffield United's lead may well be a winning one now. Stylish goal too. Oh well. Unopposed, Elliott, 2-1. Hull's leading scorer gives them hope. Andrews. Look at the space for Duffy. Paddy Kenny Kane might have caught. Now he's in trouble, is that a penalty? Hull are furious, Green went down, Kenny limps away, and half the ground held its breath, expecting the referee to point to the spot. There is, though, no question about this. It was a piece of play from the goalkeeper that belonged more on a rugby pitch than a football pitch. Stuart Green, the player, upended, and Phil Crossley, the referee, said no penalty. That's where he had hold of him. It was also the moment at which Paddy Kenny sustained his injury. Elliott. No flag. Green. Duffy! It's 2-2! Which, frankly, it should have been from the penalty spot a couple of minutes ago. But now it most definitely is. Paddy Kenny face down on the 6-yard line. 2-0 up to 2-2. They should have conceded a penalty. And it's Hull in the ascendancy now. And what are they going to do with their stricken goalkeeper? It was a brave piece of goalkeeping. He had to go for it. Equally, Duffy had every right. And the goal scorer's right knee caught Kenny on the side of the head. Parkin. Oh, and he's taken another collision with Morgan. Well, his own players are doing more damage to him than the opposition. First of all, he was clattered by Short, then by an opponent, Duffy, and now by his own captain, Chris Morgan. Unsworth. Shipley opening up, Steve Cabba didn't really get hold of it. Tom up goes Short, and Weber, and Unsworth! One giant step closer to the promised land for Sheffield United. right around this ground. 2-0, 2-2, groggy goalkeeper, nearly a penalty against them. And now, in minute number 93, the barrel-chested David Unsworth sweeps them back in front. That is character. And that is what wins promotion. Here's Cabba. And all Sheffield United have to do is keep the ball. They've done it! They have done it! A two-goal lead surrendered, a punch-drunk goalkeeper, a clear penalty not awarded against them, and then, a 93rd-minute winner from the veteran David Unsworth. Another eventful day at Bramall Lane ends with Sheffield United on the brink of the Premiership. Unsworth the match winner. Kenny a different sort of hero. They rode their luck. They battled against valiant opponents and against the elements, and they have come through in some style.
So we'd be 2-0 up, you know, we thought we were more or less home and dry, and obviously Paddy sort of being half knocked out and everything like that, you know, things were going against us. And then to Unzi to somehow even go in the box, never mind pick up the loose ball and smash it home. I think if you rewind the celebrations, you'll see that I think it was about all 11 of us were absolutely buzzing. There'd been massive sigh of relief, and I think that, you know, took us that step closer to promotion.
Good Friday, it certainly was for United. They went into the vital game at Cardiff knowing that a win would put the Blades on the brink of the Premiership.
They are now on the brink of playing among football's elite next season. 3 points would certainly send them a long way towards that, and this is Kozluk's ball into the box for Stephen Cabba, who's done really well, finds Webber, he's missed! He doesn't usually miss from there, but Danny Webber blazes the ball over. It's a great ball down the line from Kozluk, and Stephen Cabba very unselfishly pulled it back, and Webber couldn't supply the finish. Good vision from Stephen Cabba, despite the close attentions of Whitley. And Webber, well, you can see what it means to his manager when he missed. Helper again, and in the shadows, Danny Webber. Can he step out with the knock ball as part of a problem? Well, not this time. Cleared away. There's Cameron Jerome, a Sheffield United transfer target, but he's given the ball away, and Danny Webber has an opportunity here to cause Cardiff a problem. Into the box, into the net, and is that the goal that sends Sheffield United to the promised land of the Premiership? Danny Webber puts Sheffield United a whisker away from top flight football. Let the celebrations begin. Stopped in his tracks initially, Cardiff should have got it clear. Cameron Jerome looked comfortable as the ball came into him, but an awful pass put it to Danny Webber on a plate. Attacking Neil Cox, there was only one thing he was going to do, and that's find the bottom corner. And Sheffield United now a whisker away from Premiership football. All the pressure back on Leeds and Watford, thanks to this goal from Sheffield United's number 10, Danny Webber. Celebrations all round, they can taste it, can't they? He's been colossal for Sheffield United this season. A snip as well at £500,000.
So, joy for Neil Warnock and the team, but they, like the fans, must now wait an agonising few hours for Watford's results, and then till Saturday for the crucial game between Reading and Leeds.
Big thing about this season that will never leave me is all the lads sat up in the training ground upstairs watching Sky.
Well, I didn't want to watch the game, I didn't want to watch the TV or listen to the radio, because every time I did that, the team seemed to do well. So I remember having some jobs to do, and I thought, right, I'll get on my tractor. I can't hear anything on the tractor, and get some work done, which I did for about 5 or 6 hours. But we came in at half four. I came in at half four on my phone. I remember looking at my phone. It was 46 missed calls at half past four. And my wife and I just smiled when we saw the 46 missed calls. And then as I went in the door, in the back door, my wife Sharon just turned to me and said, "I'm sorry, darling, they're winning 1-0 Leeds."
It's like, oh well, you know, sort of. We thought it might have been today, but you know, we've got Leeds coming on Tuesday night. Then all of a sudden, it pipes up on the TV. We're going back to Holland Road. There's another goal being scored.
And then we waited and waited, and every time it went back, you know, there wasn't a goal. And all of a sudden, it came. There's been another goal at Elland Road, and then it just seemed like an eternity. The Sky TV, Jeff Stelling, when I see him next, I'm going to throttle him. He just said, "There's been a goal. Will it be the goal that sent Sheffield United up, or will it mean another week in suspense?" And he went on and on and on, and it seemed ages.
When it flashed up that Reading equalised, you know, the scenes were unbelievable, and you know, a day that'll stick with me, like I said, for as long as I live.
But then all of a sudden it went up to the scoreline, and even while he was talking, he still hadn't told us, but the scoreline said 1-1, and we just jumped up and hugged each other and danced around the kitchen, really, in our wellies.
At about 5-5, it was eventually confirmed. Leeds had drawn with Reading, and United were promoted. The celebrations began in earnest.
We knew sort of late Saturday afternoon that we'd done, you know, the promotion. So having a Yorkshire derby on a Tuesday was sort of the last thing we needed. But thankfully, it was a good game, and the celebrations afterwards were just absolutely fantastic.
Well, we all expected this to be the defining game, the game that Sheffield United had to win to clinch Premiership football, but with that objective already reached, Sheffield United can enjoy this occasion against their Yorkshire rivals, who themselves will have to contest the end of season playoffs. There's Michael Tong, caught there by Liam Miller, and Sheffield United in the free kick. Unsworth to clip it in towards Akinbaye, and Sullivan came and just did enough, but Akinbaye not happy with the Leeds goalkeeper. And tempers flare up in this Yorkshire derby at Bramall Lane. And the referee has to intervene. And it's a corner. It's a wicked delivery, and Butler scores past his own goalkeeper. And Sheffield United ahead. Impossible to defend. Paul Butler heads into his own goal, and Sheffield United lead at the lane. Montgomery landing Cabot. Cabot with a chance to run at the Leeds defence. Akinbaye an option. Cabot goes for glory. Good save, Sullivan. Knocked on its way. Here's Healy. Healy gets it back from Backer. Healy again. Good interplay between those two. It's David Healy. Spots the gap and finds the corner. And Leeds United are level. It's the Northern Ireland international, David Healy. Here's Akinbaye on the turn, and just over. How close was that? Nice clearance. And the referee blows full time. It finishes all square at Bramall Lane for Sheffield United and Leeds United. But the party can well and truly begin now. Months of hard work finally comes to an end, and Sheffield United can really think about Premiership football now next season.
Yeah, it's been fantastic. It's just been getting better and better. And this is, you know, obviously crowned it off beautifully. We knew we were promoted before the game, which is a bit strange, but we still played a pretty decent game. And like I say, we're going to go and celebrate now.
The last away trip for the United faithful had a happy ending, with a superb free kick from Michael Tong in the last minute securing a draw.
Come on, get your programmes!
Then at last, it was time to party, as the fans said goodbye to the Championship, with Crystal Palace the visitors to Bramall Lane. It was an afternoon of carnival mood and celebration.
Suddenly, 12 years seems worth the wait, doesn't it?
There he is. Love him or hate him, you just can't ignore the man. He has to be given every credit in the world for getting his side back to the Premiership. So, just fizz it in behind the defence, but again hitting that first man.
Now Tom goes for a curler.
Well, this boy, I think, could do it in the Premiership, Tom, in the middle of midfield, alongside Jagielka, sets himself up for the shot, clears his feet, but he doesn't start it outside the post, really, to curl into that far corner. Starts it on target, and then it ends up straight, and not low enough anyway to trouble Kurai.
All sorts of Sheffield United supporters have come along here today.
Substitution for Sheffield United coming off number 4, Craig Short. And a fantastic season for Craig Short.
And Craig Short's distinguished football career comes to an end at the age of 37. Such an important part he has played for Sheffield United, an experienced head that has been required when times have got tricky on the run-in to finishing second.
There's Craig Short down there, but I'd just like to congratulate him on a wonderful career. 37, as you said, he's had a great career. But they're resisting the temptation.
Tom, this is Gillespie now. And there's the goal! How fitting that it's the captain, Chris Morgan. A crowning end to a crowning season for Sheffield United. They lead Crystal Palace by 1-0.
Great finish by Morgan, but Gillespie's allowed all the time and space on the short corner to pick him out. You can see 2-on-1 situation. They don't get out quick enough. Good cross. A bit statuesque in there, Palace, because there's no one near Morgan as he heads it in. Look at that. Comes across his own player, Akinbay, but he still had it all to finish. That's a great shape on the header, isn't it, into the far corner. Finishes it like the best of centre-forwards. Great finish from Morgan.
His first goal of 2006, the first goal of the afternoon here at Bramall Lane. Just listen to that cheer. Brian Dean, a Bramall Lane hero. Two consecutive promotions with Sheffield United when they went from the old Division 3 to the top division back in the late 80s and early 90s. This is his 270th appearance for the club. 119 goals he's scored for them. And he's coming on to say goodbye.
He deserves this, doesn't he? I played against Dino first time around here for... He was playing for Sheffield United. Good career he's had. Real handful.
First game of next campaign.
Well, 3 minutes to go, time added on for injury. Flag flying high, and proudly as well, the Blades, Sheffield United back in the Premiership, look like finishing it with a 1-0 win. And they'll be partying, I tell you. They've been partying all afternoon.
Goodbye Championship, hello Premiership. Sheffield United's last game in the second tier of English football ends with a win. It's their 26th league win of the season. Chris Morgan, the club captain with the goal, his fourth of the campaign. Plenty of goodbyes, not just to this division for Sheffield United, but to some fine servants. Brian Dean, who only managed 2 substitute appearances since his third coming to the club. Craig Short as well. Well, it's been a terrific effort over 46 games from Sheffield United. They have been enjoying it over the last 2 weeks. Now they know that their next league game will be in the Premiership.
No, it's taken a lot of hard work and, you know, good support. And I'd never envisaged that, you know, chanting Warnock out this time last year. Yeah, that's football, isn't it? But that's the way to answer it, you know, get your own signings in. And, you know, we've got to improve, we've got to get good players in as well. But let's enjoy the moment.
Well,
After 270 appearances, the crowd said a fond farewell that day to Bramall Lane hero Brian Dean.
Brian, you did all this perhaps a long time ago, it might seem now, in 1990 with Sheffield United. Does this bring back a few memories for you?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, you know, obviously I haven't played as big a part maybe on the pitch, but I mean, this club for me is, you know, it's my home, and, you know, I'm just so happy that, you know, this time where I think I'm packing in now, you know, the club's back where it belongs.
Is that why, with all honesty, there's a small tear in your eye at the moment?
Yeah, I mean, you know, I've got a lot of good memories here. You know, some of the best times of my life have been on this pitch, so, you know, it's in the past now, but, you know, I can always look back now. I've got plenty of time to reflect.
It's been a long and sometimes rocky road for manager Neil Warnock and his family. Now he is ready for the Premiership, but the big question, is the Premiership ready for him?
I think so, yeah. I think there's enough boring people about in there, really. I think it's good to have not just me, but my team. I think my team are vibrant and excited. Yeah, we've got a little bit of naivety in certain aspects, but I think the red and white stripes, and I changed the wage strip next year, what I've picked, I think that will go down very, very well in the Premier League. And we've just got to be a little bit more professional, because, you know, you do get punished a bit more up there. But it's a great thought to think that I'm going to be pitting my wits against the best, and I'm sure the players are thinking exactly the same.
The celebrations continued as United were honoured with a civic reception and an open-top bus tour of the city. With the temperatures soaring, the Blades fans gathered at Bramall Lane to walk the route to the Town Hall. The mile-long journey took over an hour to negotiate, with the streets lined all the way with well-wishers. Even veterans like Craig Short couldn't believe the turnout, as he enjoyed the day with his daughters. The tour ended at the Town Hall, where the Lord Mayor, the press and thousands of excited fans were waiting. Having announced he was stepping down as club chairman just days earlier, Sheffield legend Derek Dooley bid an emotional farewell.
I'd like to thank you for all that you've done for Sheffield United. I'd like to thank you for this season. I'd like to thank the player, Neil, and the players.
A fitting way to cap a great season that will never be forgotten by United fans everywhere. 2006 is a vintage year. The Blades are back in the big time.